What is up, guys, and welcome to the video. This video, we're going to be talking about the PvP notes that were kind of released here the other day. This video kind of came out of the blue, just like these notes. I wanted to definitely cover it. I read over these notes yesterday, like, thoroughly, and then I just kind of skimmed over it today to see what points I want to cover. But there's definitely a lot of good changes, and with good changes come, you know, some that maybe are not so favorable. But I want to kind of cover over them, what I think is you know, perfectly fine, what I like about it, and what can be changed. So the first thing I want to talk about here is the gearing. Now, gearing for PvP is taking a complete 180, or in the sense that it's changing. Not that it's necessarily bad, although a lot of people are not happy about it, but they're making the gearing RNG-based. It's basically like the strong boxes we have now, but that's the only way you can get gear. You're not going to be able to buy it from the vendors, and I mean, I'm not too worried about this because of the other change they have going on, because right now, you know, you can choose your piece of gear off the vendor, go with whichever stats you want, but they're changing that in Legion, so no matter what gear you have, you're going to have your stat priority preset, it sounds like, when you go into a battleground. So, I mean, if you're playing an Arcane Mage and your top stat is going to be Mastery and your second one is Haste, and that's basically going to be gearing up with your item level. So the fact that your gear comes to you randomly, I don't think is as big of a deal. Just because the only thing that's really scaling up your power is the item level of the piece of gear you get. So, I mean, say you get, you know, a bracers and a chest piece and a cloak that all has crit and multi-strike on it as an arcane mage, it's not going to matter in PvP. As long as you're getting the item level there, you're going to generally become more powerful in PvP because you have the preset stats, and the only thing that changes them is the average item level that you have. So as far as the random pieces of gear goes, I don't think it's going to be as big of a problem just because you're still going to be just as powerful in PvP and you're not going to be relying on getting that one perfect piece with the one stats that you want on it. So now here they're talking about the power gap that obviously is going on. It's been going on ever since the dawn of PvP. The age-old tale of, you know, people out-gearing others and basically making, you know, new people to PvP feel completely useless. And, you know, I remember, I think they did touch on this in BlizzCon before, something about PvP. It's like, is PvP really fun if you're just stomping over the other team and not really getting any, like, it's nice to farm another team, but it's not like it's satisfying. It's not like you're growing as a player or you feel awesome because you just pulled off a clutch move or something like that. There's no real satisfaction there. It's nice, you know, once in a while, but it's, I think the downside that it provides to the other team, like, if I were never able to farm a team again, but that means I could never get farmed, I would easily take that trade in a second. And this is just kind of even out the playing field for that sense, where the newcomers in the PvP, they're not going to be getting blown over, like, basically, I mean, they can, but but the reason that they lose isn't based off their gear. So, I mean, a veteran PvPer, if they just pick the game back up after leaving in BC or something like that, they're not going to be hindered by their gear and going to just be able to, you know, get back into the game like nothing. I mean, it's really building on that skill base over the power base. And I feel like that's definitely been a big issue for a while now, gearing up new players. You know, you go into a battleground on a fresh mage or something, you're not going to really be making that much of a difference. You're not going to be able to kill somebody unless you stay in a pack. And if there's not a pack of your teammates moving around, then it's just going to be that much more frustrating, and you're not really going to feel like you're contributing anything. And then you got to head to Ashran and that whole story. And I mean, Ashran is the PvE grind of PvP. It's not fun at all. You're not really, you're just there for the gear. You're not really progressing as a player or the class. I mean, you're not learning how to play. So when you get full geared, you're going into the battlegrounds and you still kind of suck because you got to actually practice PvP in the class. Because Ashran is not PvP. Or it is, but Ashran is a raid. Like Alterac Valley, I mean, worse than Alterac Valley. Okay, so here they're talking about, you know, the set stats I was talking about before. And this is, you know, ultimately why I feel like a lot of people are definitely complaining about the RNG of gear. It's going to be an issue. People are going to complain regardless whether they know about this or not. And most of them, I feel like, are going to kind of overlook this fact. The gear you get out of your strong boxes or any other source, the stats on it don't matter. It could be versatility with crit or something, your bottom two stats, but as long as the item level of it is decent, you're still going to be benefiting from it in PvP. So let me see what to say exactly here. We said we ultimately arrived at a solution where we set player stats automatically in PvP and increase those stats based on your average item level. I mean, that alone is going to pretty much make the randomness of your gear that you get unimportant. Like, the stats on it don't matter. As long as you're getting that item level, you're going to be becoming more powerful, you know, just by having it. I mean, there is one thing I was kind of worried about this. So if people are getting more powerful based on their item level, although the gear or the power you're getting from it is going to be minor, like a fully geared player compared to somebody that's getting fresh into PvP, I mean, they say it's going to be about a 10 item level difference when it's all said and done, when you're maxed out. That's basically like having this season's honor gear compared to conquest. Like, yeah, you're going to be more powerful, but I mean, somebody in honor gear can easily take out somebody in conquest gear if they know what they're doing. So, I mean, as far as that goes, I guess it won't matter as much, but I was just worried about people stacking item levels. Like, they're just going to buy the most garbage trinkets or garbage gear just to get their item level up. I guess, I don't know. Yeah, I think I pretty much just countered my own point I was trying to make there. So I guess, yeah, that 10% increase in power isn't going to matter that much, even if somebody goes out and buys the cheapest PvE gear they possibly can just to get the boost. So, okay. Okay, now here, they're talking about, you know, the RNG of getting the pieces of gear that you need, and where was it here? Yeah, there's no anticipation about what your reward will be with the current honor system. You grind the honor, you know what you're going to get. It's not like you're hype. You're like, I finally got the honor, and it's there. I mean, you might have it for the first couple pieces when you reroll a new class, but I mean, overall, I don't think people get as excited about gear as they used to. Like, I'm a PvE-er, I still raid a decent amount, and, I mean, for a while now, I've been pretty much, had every single piece of gear that I needed from a certain Hellfire Heroic. There's only, like, two, I think, pieces right now that I need to be fully Heroic, and one of them dropped last night. It's like, it just dropped out of the blue, and, you know, I got it, but there was no real excitement about it. I mean, it's not like back in the day when I first ran Karazhan for the first time when I was a total noob and got, you know, this purple piece of gear. I mean, I thought it was the greatest thing in the world. I thought I pretty much struck oil, but I don't know. I feel like the excitement of gear has definitely kind of gone down, at least for baseline pieces. I mean, the only exceptions to that in raiding were getting my tier 2 set and 4 set and my class trinket and maybe another trinket. It's like those four or five pieces are really all that maybe gets you excited about doing something like that. So, I mean, they're talking about here the emotional experience of PvP rewards while still doing our best to minimize the amount of disappointment experience. Oh yeah, that's right. So, that was another little failsafe they got going on. If you get, say you get a piece of bracers on your first strongbox, we'll call it, and, you know, there's supposedly a system in place that will reduce the chance that you'll get those another piece of brace or another set of bracers. So I'm really curious as to how big that gap is. Like, maybe, you know, baseline every single piece of gear was there. There's 15 pieces of gear, well, 13 minus the two rings and the two trinkets. So let's say you got like an 8% chance baseline. You got no gear whatsoever out of a strong box, and you got an 8% chance. Maybe after you get those bracers, the chance that you'll get them again will be cut in half down to like 4%. So I'm really kind of interested to see if they'll release the exact stats on it and, you know, how much they're reducing the chance you'll double up on gear. Because that would be pretty interesting to see. I mean, it could really make or break. If they only reduce it by like 30% or 30% chance they'll get that piece again, that it doesn't seem like as much, and there are going to be those people out there that are really unlucky. It almost seemed like it'd be worth it just to, you know, when you get for the first time, it's cut in half, and then maybe if you get it a second time or even a third time, like, they just make it like completely low. Like, until you get every other single piece of gear, you're pretty much not going to be getting that gear again. I mean, two seems a little extreme. Like, if you get two of them, yeah, it can be bad luck, but I don't think they should cut it out as, I guess, It sounds like a stupid idea. Like, I would like them to cut out if you get two bracers in a row, they should make it so you don't want to get or can't get a third one, but I feel like that's too extreme. So maybe if they just reduce the chance, maybe you're trying to farm bracers for PvE and you're trying to get a different stat out of them, I guess it would be worth it. But yeah, it'd be interesting to see how much that reduction is. I'm ranting now at this point, so let's move on. Okay, now here is my personal favorite part of this whole change they have going on. I don't know why I'm mailing my hands around like I'm on webcam here, but so basically, right now they're keeping the system where it's like you do your raid battlegrounds or raid arenas or something like that. They're kind of adding it over onto it, looks like, where you get your first few wins and you'll be guaranteed a piece of gear. It's basically the strong box system we have now for doing three raid battlegrounds or doing the events in Ashran. So I mean, I'm kind of glad they're bringing that over, but I think it'll be more rewarding in Legion just because you're not going for that one piece of gear with the one piece of stats, because that's a big issue. I mean, I did Ashran so many times this expansion. I think I've only ever gotten two, maybe three pieces out of there that I actually used for their stats. But I guess now that they're taking that away, it will be a lot more rewarding. And the other part, this is the part where it's like they revamped kind of what they did back in was it Burning Crusade days, I guess. I wasn't really ever a good PvPer back then, so this didn't ever affect me, but when they had the rating requirements on gear. Now this isn't like that, but you're still getting rewarded for, the more or the higher of a rating you have. Like right now you just get the increased conquest cap, but that only does so much for like the first maybe a month or two, and then after that you're pretty much gear capped, and if you didn't get that high rating, then it's not really gonna matter. So right now, if you have a high rating, you're going to be getting better pieces of gear if you have a 1900 rating compared to somebody who's just capping or doing PvP just to get the couple wins in, and they have like a 1300 rating. Now, I love this. It's like PvE. I mean, if somebody's more skilled at PvE and rating, they're going to do a higher difficulty of rating and in turn get more powerful gear. And this is just taking that over into PvP, and I completely love it. Like, I was a little worried about, there really being no difference. I mean, that's always kind of been the way it has now, other than just your skill in PvP. Like, right now, everybody's geared up. Everybody's who's going for rating has full 740, but there's really not any difference other than skill that sets you apart, which skill is fine for a while, but you definitely want something more tangible, something that you can see. I mean, it used to be obviously more popular back in the day when you'd go through Orgrimmar and you'd see somebody who has like a really high rating with, the gear that goes with it now, or, if they're a mythic raider now and they have full mythic, it's definitely nice to see something like that. You kind of recognize the skill there. With PvP, not so much. You run around and, everybody has their team mag, but it's like there's no real distinction unless you actually go up and inspect the person, which who takes time to inspect people anymore? It's rare. Maybe on Durotar once in a while before you duel somebody, you'll check out their rating, but that's about it. I mean, it's like, and until you really inspect them, you have no idea. You're not just gonna walk by and be like, oh, that person is obviously 2K rated, and they could be staying next to somebody that's 1400 rated, and nobody would know the difference. So I mean, I'm really loving this. The more reward you get for, just being better at the game, and it will be kind of like the gear we have now, like the increased cap. Like eventually, everybody's gonna get probably the same item level in PvP, or maybe that's another thing I'm wondering. Maybe it's gonna be like this. Like say throughout the whole season, like you're, let's say the base item level of a fresh 110 is gonna be 800, and maybe through your PvP, like you're only gonna be getting at 1400 rating, like 840 item level PV or pieces of gear, compared to somebody who's at like 2K and they're getting like 890 item level PvP gear. Maybe it'll stay like that, and it kind of will be like the rating requirement. Yeah, you can do fine, and you're not going to be hurting if you don't have the top end gear, but as long as you don't get that rating, everybody that's above you is still going to have that edge, Which it's going to give more incentive to people getting into PvP to really push for that. I mean, that's why I feel like WoW is kind of missing nowadays. I mean, back when I first started, oh, I was going hard. I was, looking at every nook and cranny of WoW that I could and started looking on the internet just how to become a better player. And it's that drive that really makes PvP more fun for newcomers. And I mean, I guess if they don't like the drive, then they're just kind of looking for an easy cop out, I guess. They want everything, or I want to say everything handed to them, but they want it to be way more accessible when it shouldn't be. Like, I don't go up to Mythic Raiders and be like, I should be able to raid at your level just because I got a 705 item level. That shouldn't mean I shouldn't be able to get Mythic Gear too. Well, it kind of does. So, moving on. Okay, so I already did kind of a segue leading into this. So basically, there's the argument here that I'll just read the text as it is here. There's also been some concern for both PvEers and PvPers that Raiders will just do Arena to get easy gear, and Gladiators will just do Mythic Raids to get easy gear. And obviously, it kind of goes back to people can't just do that stuff. If they're good enough at it, they can. I guess they could buy it if they really wanted to, but I don't know how. I'm not too worried about that, but it goes back to the thing where getting Gladiator in PvP and doing Mythic Raids in PvE isn't something you can just go up and pick up off a weekend. If they're, playing the game at that kind of level, then they definitely deserve the rewards that they're getting. And I mean, it just all ties back into that, I guess progressing your character. Okay, so I think I covered over pretty much everything that I wanted to. We got the RNG of gear kind of covered. You got the stat or the set stats. I don't think there's anything else. I remember reading this before. It kind of made me laugh. In Legion, when a players win a battleground, skirmish, arena, or raid battleground, they have a chance to receive a piece of gear directly. Like, what if you don't do it in a raid battleground? It's mailed to you via FedEx, or it's given to your guildie, and then they got to give it to you, or something like that. Yeah. I don't know. It's quirky like that. Deal with it. But yeah, let me know what your guys' thoughts are on all these changes for PvP. I mean, I'm always one for change. After you kind of going through an expansion like this, everybody's just getting bored of the same old stale kind of thing. And even if, some of the changes aren't, what you might have wanted to see, it's definitely nice to have a change of pace going on here once in a while. I mean, that was kind of like what they did back in the day. Instead of having the 75,000 honor cap, and you'd have to get the battleground tokens to get a certain piece of gear. God, that was so long ago. I don't even know if how many of you remember that stuff, where you'd actually have to do specific battlegrounds to get a token out of there to buy a piece of gear. It wasn't just honor. But yeah, I mean, change can be positive, and I'm really hoping that this turns out for the better, and it'll be interesting to see. So until next time, guys, this is Spart out.